Hello everyone, welcome to Infinite Gyan. India derived its name from the river Indus, which is also called as Sindhu, meaning a huge sheet of water. This great river in ancient times formed the western boundary of India. The civilization that lived around the Indus and its tributaries was called the Indus Valley Civilization or the Harappan Civilization. It was the first urban civilization in South Asia, which was contemporary with the Mesopotamian and the Egypt civilization. It forms the part of proto-history of India and belongs to the Bronze Age. These are some of the major excavations in the Indus region. Lately, the civilization is called as the Harappan civilization because a major chunk of settlements have been excavated in the Ghaggar-Hakra belt that spread far beyond the Indus region. Harappa, being the first archaeological site to be discovered, gives its name to the entire civilization. There is a great deal of variation in the dates for different phases in the Harappan civilization, but in general, it is classified in three phases: the early or the pre-Harappan phase, which is said to be around 3200 to 2600 BC. It is also called as the regionalization era. It was a proto-urban phase of the Harappan civilization. It did not have large cities that defined the mature Harappan phase. Neither did it have as much expertise in craft specialization, etc. The mature Harappan phase, this is also known as the integration era. It was the urban phase of the Harappan civilization, which shows the characteristics of a full-fledged civilization. The time frame of it is around 2600 to 1900 BC, and the late Harappan phase. It is also called as the localization era, which was the post-urban phase defined by the decline in the cities. Now let us revisit our ancestors and learn about their life and culture in detail. The Harappan city was divided into two parts, citadel or the raised part and the lower part. The citadel was situated to the west of the city, occupied a smaller area, and usually the rulers of the city lived here. The lower part, common citizens lived. It was situated to the east of the city and was generally larger compared to the citadel. The city planning roughly followed a grid pattern. The streets ran from north and cut at right angles. No window faced the streets. They used burnt bricks of identical ratio of 1:2:4 in terms of thickness:width:length. The uniformity and average size of bricks was also astonishing. They had a great drainage system with covered drains. Each drain had a gentle slope so that the water could flow through it. The drains in the houses were connected to those on the streets, and smaller drains led into bigger ones. As the drains were covered, inspection holes were provided at intervals to clean them. This is a photo of one of the excavated sites. Here you can observe that the raised part is called the citadel, where the rulers of the town usually lived. As you can observe here, the network of drains is properly planned. The drains connect the houses to the bigger drains. Also, you can observe that the bricks that are used for the construction are also of uniform size. And we are talking about the time frame of 3200 to 1300 BC. The Harappan society was an urban society. Much evidence is available to understand the social life of Harappans. Based on the excavations, we can find that copper, bronze, silver, gold were the metals known to them. However, the Harappans did not know iron. They were good at metallurgy and producing alloy. They were experts in making use of potter's wheel, and they refined the art of bead making. The Harappan writing was boustrophedon, that is, right to left and left to right in the alternate lines. The Harappan script was pictographic and logosyllabic, that is, each symbol stood for a word. The Harappan script has not been deciphered yet. The mystery of Harappan script still remains, and if ever it is deciphered, it will throw much light on this culture. Here you can see the Harappan seal and the Harappan script. Each of these symbols represents a particular word. The Harappan script is bostrophedon, that is from right to left and left to right in the alternate lines. There was a great progress in all spheres of economic activity, such as agriculture, industry, craft and trade. The Mesopotamians called the Indus region as Meluha. The standard Harappan seal was a square or oblong plaque made of statite stone. There was no metallic money in circulation, and trade was generally conducted by means of barter. The rates followed a binary system in the lower denominations, like 1, 2, 8, 16, 32, 64, and then followed a decimal multiples of 160. The weights were made of chert, limestone, and statite stones, and generally cubical in shape. From the seals, terracotta figures, and copper tablets, we get an idea on the religious life of the Harappans. The Harappan civilization is considered as a secular society, as not a single structure qualifying as a temple has been found. The idolatry was practiced by the Harappan society. The chief male deity was Pashupati, represented in the seals as sitting in a yogic posture with three faces and two horns. He is surrounded by four animals. The chief female deity is the mother goddess, represented in the terracotta figures. In the later times, linga worship was prevalent. Trees and animals were also worshipped by the Harappans. They believed in ghosts and forces and used amulets as protection against them. Now let us learn about each of the famous sites that have been excavated in the Harappan civilization. The first site to be excavated was Harappa. It was excavated by Dayaram Sahini in the year 1921. Evidence of coffin burial and cemetery hedge culture is observed in Harappa. Two red stone idols of a dancing girl and naked bust of male-female genitalia is observed. Granaries are located outside the citadel. Little bullock carts and ekas, besides copper or bronze models of carts with seated drivers, have also been found in Harappa. Rig Veda Mandal 6 mentions it as Harupia, a battle site ruins. It is situated in Montgomery district of Punjab, which is now in Pakistan, on the left bank of River Ravi. Mohenjo-daro, which literally means Mound of the Dead, is situated in Larkana district of Sindh, on the right bank of River Indus. The city is an example of conservatism, as despite being flooded 9 times, they never tried to shift to a safer place. Nor did they try to build strong embankments to protect themselves from flood. Rather, they came back to the original site whenever the water table receded. It was excavated first by R.D. Banerjee in 1922 and then again by E. Mackay, Kashinath Dixit, Sir John Marshall in 1930. Great Bath is the most important public place located at the center of the citadel. Large granary is also located inside the citadel. Multi-pillared assembly hall, bronze dancing girl, college of priest, piece of woven cotton cloth, terracotta figures of a horse are the other findings at this site. A statite statue of a bearded man, supposed to be a priest king, is also found at this site. The evidence of ship or a big boat and bangles of clay have also been found. This is a photo of Great Bath in Mohenjo-daro. It measures 39 feet length, 23 feet breadth and 8 feet depth. Flights of steps at either end lead to the surface. The floor of the bath was made of burnt bricks. It must have served as a ritual bathing site. Lothal. It was excavated by S. R. Rao in the year 1957. Artificial brick dockyard connected through the Bhogavar River with the Gulf of Cambay. It was an important sea trade center and bead making factory. A terracotta model of ship with stick immersed socket has been found in this site. Painting on jar resembling story of a cunning fox in Panchatantra has been found. Houses with entrances on the main street was a peculiar feature because houses of all other sites had side entries. Evidence of double burial, that is women and men together, is observed. It is the only place along with Rangpur where rice husk has been found. It is situated in Gujarat on the confluence of Sabarmati and Bhogavar River near Gulf of Cambay. Kalibangan. It was excavated by Amalanand Ghosh in 1953 and B.B. Lal and B.K. Thapar in 1961. Plowed field was observed in Kalibangan. Fire altars showing practice of cult of sacrifice was also observed. Decorative bricks were used in the flooring only at this particular site. It is situated in Ganganagar district of northern Rajasthan on the banks of now dry course of Ghagar River. Chanhu Daru. It was excavated by N.G. Majumdar in 1931 and E. Mekke. It was the only Harappan city without a citadel. A clay model of four-wheeler and a bronze model of roofed chariot was found. It was a bead factory site as lots of beads, seals, ornaments was unearthed. It is situated in Sindh on left plains of Indus, south of Mohenjo-daro. Dholavira. It was excavated by J.P. Joshi in 1990 to 1991. It has a unique water harvesting system. The most unique feature of this site is its division into not two but three sections. An inscription comprising 10 large-sized signs of Harappan script similar to a signboard is observed in Dholavira. It shows all three phases of Harappan culture. It is situated in Gujarat and has a water reservoir. Kot Digi. It was excavated by Ghure in 1835 and Fazal Ahmad in 1955. It was a city destroyed by force. Pottery was of distinctive character, which was decorated to have developed from bands of brownish paint. It was situated near Sindh River. An interesting motif appears to have developed from bands of loop and wavy lines into a well-known fish scale pattern which later appears on Harappan pottery. Rakhi Garhi. It was the largest Indus Valley civilization site and it shows all three phases of the Harappan culture. It was perhaps the provincial capital of Harappan civilization. Banavali. It was excavated by R. S. Bhist in 1973 to 1974. Clay model of plow, high quality barley, fire altars were found in this site. Seals were found only in the lower town and not in the citadel. It is situated in the Hisar district of Haryana on the bank of now dry course of river Saraswati. Amri. It was excavated by Ghure in 1835 and by Fazal Ahmad in 1955. From this site comes the beautiful painted humped Indian bull. It was a pre-Harappan settlement and it is situated in Sindh west of river Indus. Some of the other sites that were excavated include Surkatoda, which is a coastal site located at the head of Run of Kutch, excavated by J.P. Joshi. Roper, excavated by Y.D. Sharma, which is situated in Roper district of Punjab. Rangpur, excavated by M.S. Vatsa and S.R. Rao, which is situated in Jhalwar district of Gujarat, and Alamgirpur, excavated by Y.D. Sharma, which represents the post-Harappan culture and is situated in Meerut district of Uttar Pradesh. There is no archaeological evidence which accurately provides an explanation for the de-urbanization. There is no unanimous view pertaining to the cause of decline of the Harappan culture. Various theories have been postulated. Some of these include natural calamities like floods, earthquakes, etc., decreasing fertility of the soil, change in the river course. According to some of the scholars, the final blow was delivered by the invasion of Aryans.